वेलकम टू ऑल ऑफ यू. मैं सेल्फ डॉक्टर नेहा देसाई फ्रॉम डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ केमिस्ट्री आरबीएनबी कॉलेज श्रीरामपुर. नाउ दिस इज माय फोर्थ लेक्चर इन गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी. इन द अर्लियर लेक्चर वी हैव डिस्कस्ड द डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ डिटेक्टर्स विच आर यूज्ड इन जीसी एंड नाउ वी विल स्टडी द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी. गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी इट इज़ वन ऑफ द मोस्ट वाइडली यूज टेक्निक इन केस ऑफ सेपरेशन साइंस. वाई गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी इज मोस्ट वाइडली यूज? बिकॉज गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी, विद द हेल्प ऑफ गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी यू कैन एनालाइज द कॉम्प्लेक्स सैम्पल एंड गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी इज लो कॉस्ट टेक्निक एज कम्पेयर टू द अदर टेक्निक्स. सो गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी, it has found a wide range of application in qualitative analysis as well as quantitative analysis. So, for qualitative analysis as well as quantitative analysis by using gas chromatography technique, firstly, for quantitative analysis, you are using here the triangulation process. Triangulation process means what? If it is a chromatogram that you have obtained by using the gas chromatogram on a recorder, then what you will do? You will draw the tangents. Okay? You will draw the tangents to this well-developed chromatogram, and in that case this is known as the width for the chromatogram and this is known as the height for the chromatogram. And how you can explain the things in quantitative analysis, that is, for full width half maxima, A is equal to half W into H, where A is the area under the triangulation or area under the chromatogram that represents A. A is equal to half into W into H, where W is the width and H is the height of the chromatogram. So, gas chromatography, it is used on a wide basis in quantitative analysis as well as qualitative analysis. In case of qualitative analysis, how you will determine the quality of a substance? You can determine the quality of a substance by calculating its retention behavior or a retention time. So, in this case, you will consider the retention time of different substances. So, you can calculate here the retention behavior or the retention time of the different components which are present in the mixture. Now, you can also compare this retention behavior, and by collecting the individual data of each component, you can determine the quality of a substance. So, this is regarding the qualitative analysis. Now, the third analysis that we can carry out is the detection of steroid drugs. So, the third application is the detection of steroid drugs. In case of athletics competition or any sports competition, it is very important to detect the presence of steroids present in the inside the body of a sports person. So, the detection of that steroid drugs can be carried out by using the gas chromatography. So, it is a very important application as far as the field of sports is concerned. Now, all the components which are present in the steroid, they can be analyzed by using gas chromatography. Now, the next application is the analysis of hazardous pollutants. Gas chromatography, it has found a wide range of application in the field of environmental chemistry or in order to determine the different types of pollutants which are present in air. So, hazardous pollutants such as carbon monoxide or tetrahydrofuran or carbon tetrachloride or carbon dioxide, all these hazardous pollutants, they can be analyzed by using gas chromatography. Then next is analysis of volatile fatty acids. So, gas chromatography, they have found the application in the analysis of volatile fatty acids. They can be analyzed by using GLC, that is gas liquid chromatography. Now, the next important application in terms of gas chromatography is the petroleum and petrochemical industry. When you are separating the petrol, diesel or all the fractions from the fossil fuels, then very large amount of analysis can be carried out by using gas chromatography, and for that purpose very large columns are used, and therefore petroleum and petrochemical industry, they have found a very large applications in the gas chromatography. Now, the next top application of gas chromatography is to determine the fingerprint region in the microorganisms. So, gas chromatography, it plays important role in the determination of fingerprint region in microorganisms. So, this is the next application of gas chromatography. After that, GC, it has also found main application in food industry with respect to analysis of different colorants or flavors. As far as milks and milk products are concerned, gas chromatography, it has also found a wide range of applications in milk and milk products for the analysis of particularly the aldehydes and ketones. After this application, the next important application of GC is in the field of drug and pharmaceutical industry for the preparation of different types of drugs as well as pharmaceutical products, lotions. Gas chromatography is widely used. So, the next important application of GC is in the field of drug and pharmaceutical industry. Now, the gas liquid chromatography, it also founds a wide range of application in the dairy products as well as इट इज ऑल्सो यूज फॉर द एनालिसिस ऑफ नॉन होलाटाइल कंपाउंड्स दैट इज स्पेशली द इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. ऑल द इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स दे आर नॉन होलाटाइल इन नेचर एंड फॉर द एनालिसिस ऑफ दीज सब्सटेंसेस द गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी इज यूज. सो द नेक्स्ट एप्लीकेशन इज द एनालिसिस ऑफ इनऑर्गेनिक कंपाउंड्स. सो ऑल दीज आर व्हाट ऑल दीज आर नथिंग बट द एप्लीकेशंस ऑफ गैस क्रोमेटोग्राफी. So, as far as applications are concerned, gas chromatography, it has found a wide range of application in the field of environmental industry, in the field of medicinal chemistry, for the analysis of drugs and various pharmaceutical products. They are also used in the dairy industry for the analysis of milk and milk products. Along with that, they are also used for the food technology for the analysis of various types of flavors or the colorants. So these are nothing but the different types of application, and due to the wide range of applications that gas chromatography has, it is the most widely used technique and popular technique in chromatography. Now the next point that we are going to study, these are the different types of the gas chromatography which are used. So basically, as far as the types of gas chromatography are concerned, there are four types of gas chromatography. Next point is the types of GC. Basically, there are four types of gas chromatography. That is, first one is the packed column GC, second one is the capillary column GC, third one is the program scale GC, and the fourth one, that is program temperature controlled GC. So these are the four types of gas chromatographic techniques we are going to study in detail. So we will begin with the first one, that is packed column GC. What about the packed column GC? In case of packed column GC, as the name indicates, we are using here a packed column for the analysis. This column has a length in the range of 3 to 20 feet in length. And in case of packed column GC, it is basically used for the analysis of organic compounds . It is used for the qualitative as well as quantitative analysis. In case of packed column GC, at one stroke, you can insert here 0.1 mm of a sample. And as the name indicates, you will prefer here a completely packed column. In packed column GC, length is in the range of 3 to 20 feet. Then the diameter that you are using, it is having an internal diameter in the range of 0.5 mm. And as far as the sample injection is concerned, you can insert here 0.1 mm of the sample at a one stroke for the analysis of packed column GC. Now, the second type for the analysis of gas chromatography is the capillary column GC. name indicates here, in capillary column GC, you are using a capillary column. Capillary column, these are the columns which are very long and very thin. So, these capillary columns, they are very long and very thin. As all of you know that, as per the principles of chromatography, as you increase the length of a column and as you decrease the diameter of a column, the efficiency of a column increases. So, by using the capillary column, you will get a well-resolved chromatogram. So, in this case, that is for the capillary column, you are not packing your column with any of the adsorbent material such as silica gel or alumina. Instead of that, you are using a capillary column and you are coating it on a support. That means you are preferring here a support coated capillary column. By using capillary column, as you are using a very long column here, you will get a well separated and well resolved chromatogram, and better resolution is obtained as a result of capillary column. Then the third category of the analysis is the program scale GC. So this type of gas chromatography technique, it is mostly used by the organic chemist as compared to the analytical chemist. Why organic chemist, they prefer to use this type of chromatography? The main reason is that this type of gas chromatography technique is used for the controlling the reaction mechanism. In case of organic chemistry, along with the single reaction, multi-component reactions are also there, and therefore for the analysis of the multi-component reaction, or in order to determine the different types of products and byproducts which are formed as a result of different reactants, the program scale gas chromatography is used. So mainly it is used for the analysis of organic compounds, and this is carried out at a comparatively lower temperature range. So, this is about the program scale gas chromatography. After the program scale gas chromatography, the last and most important type of gas chromatography is the program temperature controlled gas chromatography. So this is the fourth type. So in case of program temperature controlled gas chromatography, this type of analysis is particularly used for the analysis of volatile compounds. So all of you know that non-volatile compounds and volatile compound, these are the two categories of the compound, the substances which are directly converted into the vaporized form are known as volatile compound. That is, directly there is a conversion of solid into the vapors form. So for the analysis of such volatile compounds, especially the organic compounds, the program temperature controlled gas chromatography is used. As the name indicates, there is sequential control over the temperature of a column. So, in this type, that is program temperature controlled gas chromatography, instead of directly increasing the temperature of a column, you will sequentially rise the temperature. Sequentially rise the temperature means what? Suppose your gas chromatography column, it is at room temperature, then you will increase it to 35 degree Celsius to 45 degree Celsius, and in this manner, with continuous sequential increase, you will attain the desired temperature. So in program temperature controlled gas chromatography technique, the control over the temperature is the most important thing, because if there is not a control over the temperature, then what will happen? Your substance, it will pass more time in the column, and as it will take more time to pass through the column, instead of obtaining a sharp and well resolved peaks, you will obtain a broad peaks or broad bands in case of a well developed, instead of getting a well developed chromatogram. Hence, in case of program temperature control gas chromatography technique, you have to sequentially, or you have to increase the temperature on a regular basis. Now, for increasing the temperature, either two types are used, either a linear or a matrix. So you will increase the temperature in case of program control GC by either a linear way or a matrix way, and due to this program control GC, the gas chromatography, it has found the advanced feature as well as advanced application, because in this case the control over the temperature range is the most important and the fundamental phenomena of gas chromatography. So in nutshell, what we can say, that there are four types of GC. The first one is the packed column GC, where we are using the packed column for the analysis. Then the second one is the capillary column GC. For that, you are using a support coated capillary column. In that case, you are using a column which is very thin as well as very long. Then the third type, that is you are using the program scale gas chromatography, especially in the field of reaction mechanism for the organic chemistry. And the last one, that is you are using the program temperature controlled GC. So these are the points we have covered, and now one more important point, that is the optimization of GC. So whenever you have to carry out the experiment by using gas chromatography, there are different parameters that you have to check before analyzing the sample by using GC. So in that case, you have to optimize the various parameters for GC. So what are the different factors that you will consider while analyzing the GC? The first is the selection of a column. Now, if you have to analyze the sample by using GC, then you will select the type of a column. That means if you go with an open tubular column, or if you go with a packed column, or if you go with the capillary column. So depending upon the type of the sample that you want to analyze, you will select the column. Now, the second important thing is choice of a carrier gas. The carrier gas material that you are using in GC, this carrier gas, it should be inert one with your stationary phase, and it should be inert one with your sample. So if your carrier gas is reacting with the sample, then instead of getting the sharp peaks, you will get the extra peaks due to the impurities. So choice of a carrier gas, this is also important thing. Then next important thing is the detector. You have to select the proper detector in gas chromatography. Thermal conductivity detector, FID detector, ECD detector, these are the different types of detectors in GC. So depending upon the sensitivity of your material, you will select the exact type of the detector. Now, along with that, you have to select the sample injection unit. Injecting the sample inside the column is the most important thing in case of gas chromatography. So, for that purpose, whenever you are preferring a split sampling, splitless sampling or automatic sampling, so you have to select the sample injection system properly. After selecting the sample injection system, the next thing that you want to study is the temperature of the column. That is, it is very important to control the temperature of the column, and you have to regulate the column on this, regulate the column in a definite temperature range. So, along with that, you have to select the stationary phase as well as the mobile phase. Choice of stationary phase as well as mobile phase also plays important role. So what I want to say, that is, while you are doing the optimization, you have to consider all these different factors, that is a choice of a carrier gas, then proper choice of the column, then you have to select the sample injection system, and then you have to also select the different stationary phases and mobile phases. And after selecting all this, then you can actually start with the your actual experimental or procedural part. So this is all about the optimization of GC. So here our syllabus regarding the gas chromatography chapter completes. Thank you.